Good morning. Welcome to the Daily Connection. Good morning.
How you doing this morning?
Well, sir, it is a marvelous Monday, a great day to be alive in the Lord, connected with God and His Word, showing forth the praises of the one who called us out of darkness into the marvelous light.
Okay, Pastor, you go ahead out on me.
All righty. Can you hear me okay now?
I got you now.
All righty. All right. Delighted to be sharing the word of the living God this morning. Of course, when it comes to the word of God, the light is always on, as the psalmist writes in Psalms 119. His word is a lamp to our feet, a light for our pathway, and that the entrance of his word into our hearts and minds gives light and it gives understanding wherever we have lacked understanding. And so today we feed on the word of God, the faithfulness of God in his word, and the gift of his spirit, whom he sends into our hearts, crying out, Abba, Father, because we are sons. That's God's design and his pleasure for every one of us chosen in Christ from the foundation of the world to be to the adoption of sons. And so he sends that spirit to take that place of adoption through the finished work of the Lord Jesus Christ. Well, friend, we've started and continuing a series this month on the gifts in you, particularly talking about God's gifts in us, because the scripture teaches us in James chapter 1 and verse 17 that every good and perfect gift comes down from the Father of lights, with whom is no variableness, nor is there any shadow of turning. And so our God is a gift-giving God, and everything that comes from him is a gift. So we've been talking about, started yesterday in our Connected Church Online, talking about the gift of the Holy Spirit and his gifts. Listen to what it says in 1 John chapter 4 and verse 13. Hereby we know that we dwell in him and he in us because he has given us his spirit. Wow. Hereby we know that we dwell in him and he in us because he has given us his spirit. Certainly, he wants us to know that we have a home in him. In fact, that is our place, and that we are created to thrive and live. It is in God. In fact, the writer says in Acts chapter 17, verse 28, that is in him that we live, we move, and have our very being. And it is also in us that he lives and moves, has his very being in this world. And so then God sending his spirit, the Holy Spirit, the third person of what we call the Godhead, to live and remain and abide in us is evidence of his intent and purpose for us to live a connected life day by day, moment by moment, in him. Friend, important to realize when he talks about the Spirit dwelling in us, to understand that the Holy Spirit, he has been eternally with God the Father and the Son. And even in Genesis chapter 1, we see as the worlds are being created and restored, that in the beginning, God created the heavens and the earth. The earth, it says, became void and without form, and darkness was upon the face of the deep. And the Spirit of God hovered above the waters. He hovered above the earth there as the muscle and power of God to bring restoration. It's literally, as I would say, the energia of God, the energy, ability, and might of God to carry out God's word and to exact his purposes and plans. Well, that's the same way the Holy Spirit, he has come to indwell and live inside of us, to bring the words of the living God alive to us. Jesus himself said in John chapter 14 that when he, the Spirit, comes, he will teach you all things, and he will bring to your remembrance whatever things I have said to you. Friend, I want you to know that the Holy Spirit, as the third person of the Godhead coming to live within us, is an intentional design of Father God for us to be joined unto him and to be one spirit with him. And so to know and to see his power and ability at work in our lives every single day. It is said of him that he is that Spirit which raised Christ from the dead in Romans chapter 8 and verse 11. Well, if that same Spirit that raised Christ from the dead dwells in you and I and hovered in creation to bring to life all that Father God declared, I say to you today that God has sent him into your and my hearts and into our lives to do the very same thing, to bring all of God's good word to pass and to empower our lives and to empower us in doing the same in the lives of others. This has been an outreach of Connected Church. Connect with us, connected-church.com. Follow us on Facebook, Instagram, and YouTube. There you'll find these and other encouraging words to declare the love that God has to for you, that your faith might rest in him and his love and the identity that he's given you in the Lord Jesus Christ. That together, we are the difference that makes the difference that God desires and we desire in this world. We awaken to his purpose of knowing him and the love that he has for us, mobilize to his mission to making him known and sharing his love with others, and maybe sharing a couple of crisp screens with somebody.
We're still talking about that mic, aren't we?
Yes, sir.
Hey, I passed by there this morning, and I looked over there, and I said, that red light of mine, I'm going to let it shine. There. we appreciate you, Pastor. We thank you each morning for that message that you bring us, man. You condense it.
Yes, sir, and blessings on you and the Gospel Explosion family for keeping Jesus as the center of our joy all day long. Lord willing, we'll talk to you again real soon.
Hey, Pastor, you got to do it. We have a great one, okay?
Yes, sir. Bye-bye.
Bye-bye now.
All right, go in the strength and the indwelling presence of the Holy Spirit, who's sent to help us and empower us today, and to make the word of God come to life in your life today. Hey, have a great day. We'll talk to you again tomorrow.